The Ulefone Gemini Pro is the flagship version of the budget dual camera phone introduced in early 2017. We checked out if this new phone lives up to its promises. I'm Christopher for CMM, enjoy watching this review. The Ulefone Gemini Pro comes in a great looking box and packs a lot of accessories. You get a fast charger with localized plug, one red USB Type-C cable, one SIM tool, one multi-language quick start guide, a stand and carriage ring that is glued onto the phone's rear, one hard case to protect the phone's rear, and a tempered glass in addition to the screen protector applied out of the box. The Ulefone Gemini Pro is available in colors black and red. The unit we got is a black one, sadly the matte black finish is a real fingerprint magnet. The body is entirely made from metal and thus very sturdy. The antenna lines are crafted nicely so you can't almost feel them. The thickness with 8.7mm is okay, but the camera does stick out of the body quite a bit. The weight of the Ulefone Gemini Pro with 178 grams is tending towards the upper range. The build quality is great and there are no loose buttons or gaps. The SIM tray takes either two nano SIM cards or one micro SD card and one nano SIM card. The front is covered by Gorilla Glass 3 and features a pronounced 2.5D edge. The home button is from a solid state kind and thus only consists of a touch sensitive area. Above the screen we find a selfie flash as well as an RGB notification light. The Type-C port of the phone, contrary to the almost similar Humidigi Z Pro, is a standard plug and thus doesn't need cables with an extra lengthy plug. The 5.5-inch Full HD screen is good, but it needs some customization and mirror vision to look really good with popping colors. The picture looks sharp, the contrast is good and also colors look realistic and vivid with the aforementioned custom settings. The viewing angles look very decent, there is no change in color or contrast, just the brightness gets lower. What's great is that the bright line that was visible on the bottom of the screen of earlier batches is gone on the newer devices. The screen brightness is rather high, but still, outdoor readability isn't entirely perfect. Under bright sunlight, text is very readable, but stuff like pictures not so much. The screen glass during the testing period remained free from scratches, fingerprints do settle, but are always easy to remove. The touchscreen recognizes up to 5 fingers at once, and despite a minimal deficit regarding the touch resolution, it works just fine with good precision and reaction time. Packing a Helio X27 processor, the Ulefone Gemini Pro potentially packs quite a punch in the processing department. Sadly, the phone suffers from the very same issues that all Helio X27 phones are plagued by. The performance isn't consistent at all. At times, the phone runs perfectly smooth and snappy, but then again it suddenly starts to show some stutter in the UI. Surprisingly, this issue for the most part is present in normal applications only. Stuff like games, however, is handled fine. Even demanding high-end games run rather smooth on the phone. Oz Broken Kingdom and Unkilled, for example, both run well on highest graphics settings. One problematic thing is heat. The SoC after 45 minutes of gaming can reach temperatures of up to 85 degrees Celsius, which is a lot. A large chunk of that reaches the phone's rear, which means especially with high outdoor temperatures, this can get rather uncomfortable. One positive point is memory. The phone packs 4GB of RAM and those are rather speedy. The internal memory is 64GB in size and also reaches decent speeds. MicroSD cards can be formatted as both internal and portable memory and reach decent reading speeds. Writing, however, is a bit slow. There also is nothing to complain about sensors. The phone packs everything important, gyroscope and compass both did work fine all the time. The fingerprint scanner isn't the fastest, but it is very reliable, which makes it perfectly usable on a daily basis. The Ulefone Gemini Pro runs Android 7.1.1 and at the time of testing the security patch was dated to May 2017. The phone runs stock Android with no optical customizations and without any significant bugs. The Ulefone Gemini Pro is shipped with multi-language support and also the Google Play Store comes pre-installed. Some additional features are various gesture options, but those have all been there on other Chinese phones before, so nothing unusual. More useful features are the possibility of network access control for Wi-Fi and mobile data, as well as an energy-saving mode with energy profiles, and the possibility of changing the on-screen button's order. By the way, there is no way to disable the on-screen buttons since there are no touch buttons sub-screen. You can only use the home button for basic navigation, but depending on the settings, you either can't trigger home or the app switcher with it. The reception quality in mobile networks is very good and the phone supports band 20 LTE. Wi-Fi reception quality is very good too, but the throughput is a little slow considering it supports AC Wi-Fi. But since there is almost no bandwidth drop when moving one floor below the router, you still can't complain about Wi-Fi. GPS does work absolutely flawless too. The phone gets a fix in no time and finds lots of satellites with a great signal strength. Navigation works perfectly and while doing tracking, the phone even recognized when you change from one side of the road to the other. The mono speaker inside the lower frame does sound quite okay. It reaches an awesome volume with a surprisingly low amount of distortion and there also is a slight bass playback. The headphone jack delivers a flawless clear output with a proper volume level and no static noise. The telephony quality is very decent as well and the noise cancelling works well too. The Ulefone Gemini Pro packs a dual camera based on two Sony IMX258 sensors, one of them operating in black and white mode. The aperture is f2.0. Under good lighting conditions, the shutter time is short, but the camera takes a while to focus. Moving objects are captured sharp. The quality of the pictures isn't consistent. Sometimes they look good, sometimes they don't. Often there are random unsharp spots in pictures, which looks like a software issue. In general, the amount of detail in landscape shots isn't very good. Those pictures look kinda mushy, even with good lighting. Sometimes they also can look washed out or foggy. It is really a thing of luck if a shot looks gorgeous, mediocre or totally crappy. The only pictures that come out consistently good are close-ups and macro shots. These show a decent amount of detail and sharpness. With bad lighting, only pictures taken on a tripod look good, but then they really do. Just look at those lightning shots. Anyhow, when using no tripod, you only get blurred shots, and that is even the case when using the LED flash, which basically is very bright. A very positive surprise was the bokeh mode. Once getting used to it and once you learned how to use the manual settings available for it, you get very usable results. What's nice is that the bokeh mode is always active, not like on the OnePlus 5 where it only works under certain circumstances. But you definitely have to get used to editing pictures afterwards. There is a refocus feature which you have to use for proper results. It's not that totally automatic bokeh effect thing. You need to work a bit on it, but it can be worth it as you can see. One highlight of the Ulefone Gemini Pro is the possibility of recording bokeh videos in 4K resolution. If you take care to get these settings right and not capture something that is moving too much, the results can look absolutely gorgeous. Normal 4K videos, similar to pictures, show a lack of detail, which makes them look less crisp and sharp as you would expect from 4K content. When recording something that is a little closer, however, the amount of detail and sharpness is much better. Videos do look smooth and the audio quality actually is great. Sadly, the stock camera app does not support EIS and there also is no continuous autofocus. The 8-megapixel front camera only creates pictures with lots of noise and very bad detail, so it definitely isn't a selfie camera. That's sad since the front LED flash is very bright, which would have made it a great low-light selfie phone. The front camera can record videos in full HD and those actually look a tad better than pictures. Battery life of the Ulefone Gemini Pro was very disappointing. Despite a 3650mAh cell, we only reached an average screen on time of 4 hours 20 minutes, which by far isn't enough for power users. Fast charging doesn't work correctly as well. 2 hours of charging time are too much for PE+. Also, the charging curve is rather linear. Verdict: the Ulefone Gemini Pro does a lot of things right in important categories and can be a good deal if you get it cheap. But it has some obvious flaws, with the most important ones being the heat it generates under load as well as the high energy consumption. Those flaws are quite significant and definitely make the phone less attractive for a large group of potential buyers. Now, if Ulefone can improve this with future updates is something that remains to be seen. So make sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the bell button to not miss any future updates on the Gemini Pro here at CMM. So that's all for this video. A shop link and more information is located down in the video description. I was Christopher for CMM. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.